The course we are going to do today is psychotropic analgesic nitrous oxide, or PAN, for conscious sedation. We're going to concentrate on the theoretical rather than the practical basis of practice, so that you've got adequate theoretical background so that you can practice this technique confidently and without any problems. There is abundant evidence that for routine ambulatory dentistry and any other form of minor surgery, including medical surgery, that analgesic nitrous oxide is the safest, most effective agent for achieving conscious sedation. And this was from an article published recently in the South African Dental Journal.
While you're having a look at this disclaimer, I wanted to explain to you how this third edition arose. Edition 1 and 2 were prepared largely for dentists and maxillofacial surgeons. But since the last edition, it has become apparent that there's great interest in the technique amongst medical professionals, particularly for its use for treating minor surgical cases and also for its use for treating substance abuse withdrawal states. Nonetheless, whatever is presented in this presentation applies equally to medicine and dentistry. And for this reason, this presentation is now aimed at both medical and dental professionals. I would like to draw your attention to the following caveat. The purpose of this presentation is to give medically and dentally qualified practitioners a theoretical background only in order to be competent to administer nitrous oxide oxygen conscious sedation correctly. Further hands-on training is essential, so this does not replace hands-on training, so you will require a short hands-on training session to learn the technique, which actually is very simple and can be done in a couple of hours.
This talk on conscious sedation with PAN, or nitrous oxide oxygen, is going to be divided into 5 sections. Number 1, introduction and definition. 2, physiology and pharmacology of PAN. 3, the advantages of PAN sedation for patient and doctor. 4, practical aspects, mainly from the theoretical point of view, but which will give you some very good pointers to the practical issues. And finally, the financial viability. Let us now start with the introduction and definition. What is psychotropic analgesic nitrous oxide? Psychotropic analgesic nitrous oxide deals with the anxiolytic and mood elevating and anti-stress effects of low concentrations of nitrous oxide mixed with high concentrations of oxygen, hence PAN. Many of these properties are because PAN is an opioid. PAN therefore lends itself as an almost ideal agent as a sedative or anxiolytic for many purposes, including surgery and other applications, including use as an experimental, diagnostic, therapeutic tool of the endogenous opioid system that my colleagues and I have been using over the last 25 years. What is conscious sedation? Well, there are many definitions. The one I like is a state of sedation in which the conscious patient is rendered free of fear, apprehension, and anxiety through the use of pharmacological agents. When dealing with conscious sedation, the patient always maintains a patent airway, normal laryngeal and cough reflexes, and they respond appropriately to physical or verbal commands, and therefore their state of consciousness is only very slightly obtunded, if at all.
Clearly, it is very important to understand what the goal for using PAN sedation is. And to put it in a nutshell, it is to relax the patient with minimal analgesia. Adequate analgesia almost always needs local anaesthesia. Indeed, attempting to use pan sedation without local anesthesia almost invariably results in excessive sedation, and this has the unfortunate effect of increasing the side effects without adequate analgesia.
Let's now deal with the second section, which concentrates on the physiology and pharmacology of PAN. The first thing that I would like to emphasize very strongly is the impeccable safety of nitrous oxide oxygen sedation or PAN sedation. As you can see from these quotes, I think the most significant thing is that they're by different authors. Clark and Brinnick, who've written the standard textbook, Stenquist, who wrote an editorial in a Swedish medical anesthesiology journal, and myself, who's published widely on this field, all agree that it is an extremely safe agent. The undeniable safety of PAN sedation is well shown by the fact that there have been millions of cases of the gas and oxygen being used for conscious sedation in dentistry. Indeed, in 1999, 4.9 million cases were completed. So over a 50-year period, there have literally been millions of cases of PAN sedation, and yet not a single case of litigation has occurred against a practitioner using the correct equipment. This in a country well known for its highly litigious behavior. Despite the undoubted safety of PAN sedation, one must realize that conditions do apply for the safe use of nitrous oxide oxygen sedation. It is essential to use customized sedation equipment with a scavenging device for operator and staff safety to avoid chronic exposure of personnel to low pollutant levels of N2O.
While you're having a look at this disclaimer, I wanted to explain to you how this third edition arose. Edition 1 and 2 were prepared largely for dentists and maxillofacial surgeons, but since the last edition, it has become apparent that there's great interest in the technique amongst medical professionals, particularly for its use for treating minor surgical cases and also for its use for treating substance abuse withdrawal states. Nonetheless, whatever is presented in this presentation applies equally to medicine and dentistry. And for this reason, this presentation is now aimed at both medical and dental professionals. I would like to draw your attention to the following caveat. The purpose of this presentation is to give medically and dentally qualified practitioners a theoretical background only in order to be competent to administer nitrous oxide oxygen conscious sedation correctly. Further hands-on training is essential, so this does not replace hands-on training, so you will require a short hands-on training session to learn the technique, which actually is very simple and can be done in a couple of hours.